Hi Libra, what's up? Welcome to your August reading. I hope you're having an amazing day. Thank you so much for being here. Thank you for all of your love and your support. We're going to be seeing what messages you come through for you guys, get some insight, guidance, overall see what you need to know, look out for, or be aware of. If this reading is helpful or insightful, let me know by leaving a like, comment, and subscribe. If you'd like to book a private reading with me, the info's in the description box down below, and let's get into your reading. Libra, what's going on for Libra during the second half of August 2024? What do my Libras need to know, look out for, or be aware of during this time? Okay, we have Full Moon in Aries, a fiery climax approaches, along with the answers you need are coming. Full Moon in Gemini. So, Cancer and Scorpio also had this card come out this week. So, you may be dealing with one of those signs, but it seems like you're getting some spicy answers. A fiery climax approaches, a new start is coming at the bottom of the deck. Okay, give me one more for Libra. Right? I'm reading for Libra. Yes. I had a brain fog for a second. I was like, am I reading for Aries or Libra? Because all of a sudden, I thought I was reading for Aries. Aries started to take over. And I was like, wait a minute. No. But Aries is your counterpart. Maybe you got Aries placements. I know that there's a few of you out there with an Aries moon. Or you are a Libra moon. Libra rising or something like that. Hey, I know there's a few of y'all out there. All right. What else going on for Libra? Conclusions are within reach. Well, very true. Confidence is key to your success. Leo energy at the bottom. So, there's a conclusion. You can answer. We got triple full moon energy for you. So, things could be getting a little hectic, a little spicy, a little crazy, maybe a little bit heated, okay? Emotions could be running high. Oh, you're going to feel a huge release of energy over these next couple of weeks. So prepare yourself, Libra, because it's about to get maybe a little messy. I don't know. We're going to get the animal cards. I am very curious. Conclusions are within reach. What are you finding out with these answers that are coming in? I don't know. It feels dramatic. Feels like it could get a little dramatic. Maybe this is between you and a sibling. You and someone very similar to you, right? Gemini, the twins. There could be someone mirroring you. Huh. Let's see. What's going on for Libra? What's going on for Libra? Okay. Phoenix, the vulture. Yeah, like there's this huge, like, fuck. What the hell? Libra. I almost called you Aries again. I don't know why Aries keep coming through. We got a lot of fiery energy. I feel like, honestly, there might be breakups. There might be, because the vulture is all about clearing, cleansing, releasing of anything. Oh my god, yeah, the panther. I feel like there could be some sort of breakup in the air, or like separating yourself or removing of something. There's this extraction. There's something you're breaking free from. And this Phoenix is an energy of like burning bridges. With either it could be just something completely within you, like you're burning some sort of old identity. Because even Aries is the first house. I don't know what your rising sign is, so that's going to be different for everybody. But just generally speaking, Aries is the first house. It is how you identify yourself. It is how you show up in the world. It is like your character. It's, you know. So there's something about maybe who you are as a person that's changing, or like, you know, you're going through this metamorphosis. You're morphing into something else, something different. And Gemini, that's third house, that typically does talk about communities. Maybe it can talk about education. It can talk about your neighbors, even siblings, things like that, right? So as you're changing, as you're going through all these big shifts, personal shifts, maybe your identity is changing, how you identify and view yourself is changing, how you show up. You know, maybe that's affecting your surroundings, where you live, who you surround yourself with. Maybe this is about your job, certain colleagues you have, or friends, friendship circles, or just acquaintances that maybe you have. And then the conclusions within reach is like all about endings and closure and letting go. And, you know, something's reaching a conclusion. And so the fact that literally the Phoenix, which is all about transformation, rising from the ashes, when all that was lost and burnt to the ground is being rebuilt. It's completing one chapter of your life and starting over, starting fresh, but coming back stronger and better than you were before. Vulture can be intense. Vulture can be, well, it's talking about cleaning up the remains, right? The remains of whatever that was left after you rise from the ashes as this phoenix. Whatever remains, the vulture comes to clean it up. He'll eat that shit. Literally. And the panther, which is panther and the vulture. This is, again, there's a reason I was like, this feels kind of like dramatic energy in the air for you, Libra. So, it's because we're gearing up for eclipse season. So you're going to want to put your seatbelt on. You might be feeling very, very, like, frustrated, or even for some, sexually frustrated. You got to find an outlet some way, some shape, some form. Get this energy moving through your body. Find a way to get this out so that it doesn't stay stuck within you and create a bunch of blockages. Okay, so you're going to need to find a way to transmute through this energy. Because it's, yeah, I'm seeing even at the bottom, I didn't even see this until now, the gazelle. You could be feeling like restless, a little bit antsy. Oh my god, I just got a cramp. Ow! Right in my shin. Right in my motherfucking shin. And I didn't do anything. I'm just getting a cramp. Why would I get... Huh? That's so weird. Okay, anyways. Huh. If that's you, comment down below. But we don't... Spirit, don't be playing like that. Don't be playing like that. Get grounded. Okay, I'm putting my foot down because there's like this little foot thing that I rest my feet on sometimes. Putting my feet on the ground. I'm grounding with you. Okay. So yeah, the gazelle, definitely thinking a lot. You could be being your own worst critic right now. So watch out for that. Be mindful. Be kind. Be patient. Be compassionate to yourself as you're going through this transformation. There's something here. Gazelle and the beaver. Okay. Beaver, the crocodile. Something you're working on. Something you're putting in a lot of energy. At the moment, it might not appear what you had thought it was going to be, but just keep going. Okay? The crocodile's underneath that saying, like, just wait. Don't jump to conclusions. The transformation isn't over just yet. All right? Let's get into the tarot. Honestly, like, let's see what's going on. Let's see what really is happening. I've got something in my eye. There we go. Okay. Okay, what's going on for Libra? Yeah, this feels like there might be some dramatic twists. This deck's ready. Please show me clearly what is going on for... Oh! Lovers, and it flipped out in the reverse. Gemini energy. Answers you need are coming. But the Page of Pentacles at the bottom of the deck. Okay, so... There might be something that you've been pouring a lot of energy into, and something about this is just unrequited, out of balance. Maybe you've outgrown. It's just not the same as it used to be, is what I'm hearing. Just not the same as it used to be. Page of Pentacles at the bottom. Three of Pentacles. Queen of Pentacles. This could be in work. This could be a friendship. This could be... Shows that you have a new opportunity, you guys. There's something else coming on in. So if there's something right now that's not really in alignment with you, please be patient. Temperance also at the bottom. Temperance and death. Please be patient with yourself as you're going through these changes, as you're going through Three of Swords, as you're going through some growing pains. Please be patient with yourself because there will be a lot of improvements. And this is also like personal growth and development that's helping you really align and step into who you're supposed to be. But like, yeah, this lover's reversed. Could be a talk about connection or relationship of some sort. There could be unrequited feelings, or just like lack of effort on someone's side. Could be you, could be someone else. You might be getting clarity on that or answers on that. Or this is like a conclusion. Okay. Maybe there's separation, right? Lover's reverse can even talk about that. Inability to commit to something. Oh shit, you see that card? It is the King of Wands. So where are you going? You taking some sort of action? This is all about succeeding. So there's, you know, even going back to the Lovers reversing the King of Wands, it's like you might be looking at someone or something in your life that maybe feels out of reach. The King of Wands, he's very persistent. He doesn't quit very easy. When he has his mind set on something, he will do whatever it takes to achieve. All right, so I'm kind of getting, like, if that's you, this King of Wands, it's like you see something that maybe is off and you're, like, determined to try and, like, make it work, or it's like you're not quitting, or at least I don't, the way he's even looking over at the Lover's Reverse, it's like there's something you're not quitting on this, at least as of yet. Knight of Swords, the bottom with the Chariot. Yeah, I still see, like, you're moving forwards, you're going somewhere, you have certain plans, and you're moving quite quickly, Chariot and the Nine of Cups, towards some sort of personal desire, wish fulfillment, or dream. Let's see, the Nine of Cups, Ace of Swords. Well, you see the path is crystal clear. The path is crystal clear, and so you are continuing down. So again, the answers you need are coming, you're getting those answers, and it's pushing you on this path. So where are you going? Not quite sure. Let's see. How is this unfolding for Libra? For me, oh my god, stop. It's a huge stack. Seven of Wands at the top, though. So, you know, this is something that aligns with the core value. This is something that you may feel like you have to fight a lot for, though. Is it worth the fight? Is it worth the fight? That's something you could be asking yourself. Perhaps you're going to be getting clarity over these next couple of weeks to determine whether or not this is worth fighting for, or worth the amount of effort that you're investing in this path, in this place, person, situation, goal. You know, show me more. What's going on for Libra during this time? Seven of Pentacles. So seven seems to be your number, 77. Maybe that's your age. But so Seven of Pentacles, time will tell. So you can continue to put energy into this, but you're going to reach a point where you need to take a step back and consider the amount of energy you're putting and investing into this, and what is the return, and what adjustments are necessary, if necessary. And, you know, do you wish to continue? It's kind of like if you're, you know, you have Netflix and it's playing a show, maybe you fall asleep and then you wake up a few hours later and it has a little screen. Are you still watching? Do you wish to continue? It's just like, you know, do you wish to continue on this path? Do you wish to continue on this road? You need to trust yourself, trust your ideas, trust your direction, but also, like, know your worth, know your value. King of Swords at the bottom, right? You have to be practical about this, or at least look at the facts. Look at the facts, what's in front of you. You might need to analyze the situation a little bit more, but this is all about being honest with yourself, honest with other people. This is about being smart, wise, intelligent with your decision. And, you know, the King of Swords, if he's putting energy, he's watering this grass and the grass is dead, he might be like, fuck it, I'm going to get new sod. I'm not going to waste all this water, all this grass seed, all this time waiting for this dead grass to come back. I'm going to just go to Home Depot. I'm going to go get some new sod. And that might just be more efficient, right? The King of Swords, he's a very efficient player. Well, not player, but you know what I mean. He's like, he doesn't, he's just very smart and very, it's not really emotional here. It's more just like being practical and being like, okay, well, what's the practical approach about this? So King of Swords, the Devil, and the Hermit. Okay, so you know what I'm also seeing here? Hermit and the Devil. King of Swords, Devil, Hermit, wow. Okay, first of all, King of Swords with the Devil. You don't have time for this destruction or destructive behavior, destructive energy, or energy that's just simply toxic or really not serving you, really creating more chaos than good in your life, right? And the King of Swords, he sees through this clouded confusion, distortions. He sees through that. And the King of Swords, the Devil, he's like, I gotta cut this out. You're blocking me, or you're holding me back, or this is slowing me down, or, you know. So the King of Swords, he's very disciplined. And, you know, even if his heart might be pulling at him, his logic kicks in. He's just like, nah, like, this is the way it's gotta be. I gotta be smart, and I gotta, like, be tactful. I gotta handle this Devil the right way. So it's like, again, if this is like a habit, if this is like something that you've been obsessing about, or, you know deep down in your core, like, this isn't healthy, you got to step into that King of Swords mode, all right? Some of you, Hermit to the Devil, okay, you might want to take some time and really reflect and go inwards and sit with yourself. Because some of y'all, okay, I'm kind of picking up, like, if you're holding on to this potential You're holding on to the potential of something or someone, right? If you were to sit with yourself and ask yourself, what if this is it and nothing changes? Are you satisfied? Is that okay? Right? Because if, like, going back to the lovers, if this is a person, which we're going to clarify this, get a little bit more details. I don't know what the fuck. That could definitely be a person, but this is something that's also, like, could be about a job too, or maybe it affects your money or your work. But anyways, if you sit with yourself here, hermit to the devil, if nothing, if this situation, this is it, and this is it forever, is that enough? You can't change it. It's showing here. It's like, if you, are you willing to sacrifice yourself to the devil? Like, that sounds so dumb, but like, you get me, you get that? So like, spirit wants you to kind of sit and contemplate the effects this has had on you, and you got to weigh out the pros and cons. You got to, like, because clearly, like, the devil's saying, hey, this is not okay. Like, this is, you can't even fucking quiet your mind here. With the hermit, it's like peace and solitude and, you know, introspection and, you know, doing the inner work and being kind of at peace. But the devil's chaotic. He's like, he won't shut up. It's like, your peace seems to be disturbed, or it's constantly like, there's this reckless behavior. Like, there's this reckless vibe. I don't know. It's something that is just, King of Swords, he's not going to tolerate that shit. He's like, I need my silence. I need my quiet. I need my peace. I need a, you know, so you got to be responsible here. Emperor and Justice, literally, you need to be responsible. Not only just for yourself, but for even like your future. Your future depends on you, literally. So, and we have Aries energy again coming out. Virgo and Capricorn. Okay. So Seven of Pentacles, the energy you're putting into this. Is it working? It's like you either continue doing what you're doing, or you give less, or you give more. I mean, I don't know what your situation is, but something might need a change. I definitely think something has to change, right? If the devil didn't show up, I probably wouldn't say that. But the fact that the devil showed up there, King of Swords, yeah, I think something about this has to shift, or there needs to be some sort of adjustment. So that's connected to this conclusion. Certain answers that you're receiving, or clarity that you're understanding, new perspectives, it's going to help you reach some sort of conclusion, and then you're going to take that conclusion and do something with it. I don't know. Let's keep going. What else going on for Libra? Ten of Swords. Oh, well. And the Queen of Swords. Well, you might be cutting something out. Ten of Swords is an energy of endings. It is about seeing the truth. Literally, the affirmation in this deck. It says, I see the truth in this ending. So, you know, give it a little bit of time. See what happens. But perhaps it's time to call this over. Call it quits. Or lay this to rest. Queen of Swords at the bottom. So now we have the Queen, we have the King, now we have the Queen. Queen of Swords, it is your energy, Libra. Protect what matters to me. So again, kind of stepping into that logic, that being like practical here. Ten of Swords and Queen of Swords. Well, Queen of Swords is like, okay, well, clearly this can't go on anymore. Clearly this is it. This is the end. And so let's see, Queen of Swords, Knight of Swords, and the Three of Wands. So this is now bringing quick changes to your future, like near future changes. What is this? Three of Wands, Eight of Swords. So right, Three of Wands, Eight of Swords. It might be hard to see or imagine what your future is going to look like after making this choice, or after ending this thing, or this ending you're going through right now. Again, everyone's on different timelines. It might take a little bit of time to, like, readjust. Let's see. Let's keep going. I think I want to pull you a couple more animal cards, too. Because the way that the animal cards came out, it feels like... Okay, hold on. Let me just see. I'm getting distracted. Show me more. What's going on for Libra? I keep wanting to say Aries. It's so weird. What's going on for Libra in the month of August 2024? Thank you so much. We have the High Priestess. Okay, so there's this deep inner knowing. Also, the sun sticking out here. Leo coming through. There's this deep inner knowing. Five of Wands. But yet, there's this inner conflict. High Priestess of the Five of Wands. This is representing inner conflict. You know, do I listen to my intuition? Is my intuition, is that even my intuition? What if it's not? What if there's another way? There's this vibe where you could be resisting. That's the word. You could be resisting this intuitive knowing, this deep inner knowing. You might be having a hard time trusting it. Let me see. Five of Wands, Ace of Swords, and the Five. Here's the thing, though. You see it for what it is. You literally see it for what it is. Five of Wands, Ace of Swords, Five of Pentacles. I don't think much is coming out of this, right? We go from the Seven of Pentacles, and we're like, okay, do you continue to put more energy into this? Like the grass, the dead grass. Is it worth wasting all this energy, all this water, trying to revive this grass? Not saying, or is it better to just go to Home Depot? Is that a store? Home Depot, go get yourself some new grass. Like, I'm just saying, we're just talking about grass. I don't know why, that's just the image that comes to mind, right? So, I mean, you see what you get. You get what you see. What you see doesn't change the circumstance. So, it's about acceptance, though. There's something that you're accepting here. Okay, and like, let's pull one more. Your intuition knows it's time. Pisces energy. So, I mean, it could be from now to the eclipse we'll have in Pisces, the full moon eclipse in Pisces coming up in September. If you don't, I kind of am seeing that there might be a timeline here where you might give it a little bit, you might give it another month or so by Pisces season. Or not, why did I say Pisces season? By that full moon eclipse in Pisces, a lot of distortions, a lot of illusions might be shattered, like where you will see the truth. If you're not seeing the truth about the situation now, or even if you're kind of like lying to yourself or excusing something by this eclipse next month, all illusions will be shattered. Temperance. But okay, so hypersensitive temperance. This is all about surrendering, embracing, trusting, making peace, being in flow, this natural flow. So, and the Page of Wands, which is a card of optimism and joy and happiness and fulfillment. So, I think at first, whatever the fuck we're talking about here, Libra, you know your situation. But I think at first, right, with that Five of Wands and the Five of Pentacles, Ace of Swords, that Ten of Swords or whatever, I think at first there's this resistance to this change, to this loss, to this ending, to this whatever the hell. But as you start to surrender and embrace, the easier, the more in flow, the more peaceful your life is, the more you are not trying to control things that are way beyond your control. And like, you're more chill. Like, it seems like you're way more at peace. You're way more zen. You're way more calmer. And just like, you know, whatever is truly meant for you, you don't have to force. If you're forcing something, is it really worth that? Is it really meant for you if you have to force it? You know? Something like that. Page of Wands, Two of Pentacles, and the Six of Cups. It looks like Six of Cups and the Fool. You might have a return of a past situation. That's going to be up to you. That might be a little bit of a test. Maybe not. Let's see. Underneath the Fool, Ace of Pentacles, Page of Swords. Okay. So, yeah. I mean, I do see here you'll have some sort of decision, some sort of choice, maybe to start over, to revamp something from your past. That might be something that you're willing or open to, as long as it is healthy and it's not fucking up your energy, or, you know, like you're still at peace, like you're, you know, like it's not toxic, right? Go back to that devil, and I can't remember what else was there, but it was like King of Swords and the devil and something else. Was that with the Ten of Swords? I can't remember. It doesn't matter. But so you do have something coming up about your past, a new start, perhaps, some sort of new beginning here. Ace of Pentacles as well. So this might be something to do with your money or a job or even a friendship too. Could be up in the air right now. No, I don't get that bad vibes from that either. I feel like this is pretty genuine or pretty like positive stuff. So that's cool. I think you're like embracing, like, okay, whatever's truly meant for me, won't pass me by, like, embracing that shift. Now, I said I was going to pull another animal card just because the way it started with the phoenix and then the vulture and then the panther. It's just like, okay, so, like, kind of what's the end result here? Like, what's the outcome of all this? And then I can clarify a couple of these tarot cards. Just kind of seeing, like, outcome energy for Libra as Libra's going through these shifts, changes, as Libra's getting these answers and reaching these conclusions. What's, like, the end? What's the outcome? My bad. The end result slash outcome of how Libra is doing in this situation. Let's see. The Eagle. Interesting. So embracing change, definitely divine orchestration. We have the Bat at the bottom of the deck. Really, these cards go hand in hand. Like, all these cards that came out for you, talking about significant change, transformation, and soul lessons, big growth, and illumination of the truth here, okay? And the Eagle comes out when you're entering a brand new cycle. This is bringing up some karmic events, karmic lessons. Your soul's here to learn, transform, overcome, create new paths for yourself and your soul. Okay, anything else? And then I can clarify. Anything else about... We have the Beaver and what is sticking out? The Hawk. Literally... So, Hawk is talking about the bigger picture, sudden news and changes coming in, being open for some surprises, right? The Beaver is just talking about continuing to put energy into this, continuing to learn these lessons, continuing to embrace this change. Like, so, as you show up and as you are embracing this new chapter slash, like, new cycle, and you're in this surrender mode, you're like, okay, you know what? I make peace with this. I accept the situation for what it is. I'm not going to force this. I'm not going to stress about it. I'm just going to allow it to be like it is what it is, right? Then that's when the tides turn, or then that's where things really start to shift for you in your highest good. So that's cool. We have the Snake and the Dolphin. Now, see, that's kind of where the Snake can sometimes get locked or stuck in certain patterns or cycles. But the Dolphin's underneath that, which says it's like getting locked or stuck in a pattern that brings you joy. So that's not a bad thing. it's just about, like, there's something about comfortability here. Okay. You might be pulled out of something that... I don't know what the fuck... What? Snake and the Dolphin. You might be pulled out of this... comfortable position. It might be a little bit awkward at first, but it actually leads to a lot of, like, joy, happiness, and fulfillment. So, okay, I'm gonna stop with the animal cards. Shit. Why did I do that? Was that necessary to use those animal cards? I don't know. I just felt like I should, but now I'm like, damn, we don't have a lot of time to clarify these cards. Let me just see, let's look into this Ten of Swords. See what's coming to an end for you. No, Lover's Reverse. Yeah, fuck. Sorry. Let's look at Lover's Reverse. We'll look at the Ten of Swords, and we'll look into, like, High Priestess and Temperance as together, like a grouping. Okay, Lover's Reverse. Please show me clearly what is this Lover's Reverse about for Libra. Hangman tried coming out, so this is something that is kind of out of your control. We have Strength. So you've been really, like... You've been pulling your weight. I kind of feel like you've been the glue in a situation, or you've been keeping something together, keeping something from falling apart. Or you've been, like, overexerting yourself, doing the most. So we have the Queen of Cups. Talking about the Lover's Reverse. I feel like... Chariot. Five of Pentacles. It's like you've been putting so much energy, so much emotion, so much investment, investing so much of yourself, going above and beyond. And then we have the Five of Pentacles at the bottom, which is saying you're going above and beyond, and where is this getting you? Kind of like you're reaching, just barely grasping, getting like breadcrumbs. Page of Pentacles. Yeah, this whole, like, vision, this potential future, something for your potential future. It's not even here right now, but, like, you're, like, holding on to this vision, this idea. Let's see, Temperance and the Queen of Wands. You've been hella patient. You've been so fucking patient, okay? So freaking understanding. So understanding. So then why the Ten of Swords? Why is the Ten of Swords here? Not the Ten of Swords for Libra. What's coming to an end? King of Swords. Well, again, this is, goes back to what I was saying earlier with the Devil and the King of Swords, or then we have the Queen of Swords come out. And so, like, seeing things for what it is, being logical, being practical, and be like, okay, I'm putting and extending and giving and investing so much of X, Y, and Z to this thing, this place, this person, this blah, blah, blah. It's just not, what is this doing for me, right? Or even if it's a habit of yourself that you keep falling into, or you keep doing the same old thing, knowing it keeps giving you this result that you're unhappy with, or you're holding on to this, like, potential of something, but, like, in reality, I don't know. And so it's about seeing things for what it is, right? And so that's what this ending is, too. It's, like, even just, like, just accepting the reality of whatever this is. Ah, Five of Cups. And you might be sad about it, or you might be emotional about it, or, you know, there's definitely heaviness here. This may make you emotional here. It may make you feel, you know, kind of disappointed, or very disappointed. Right? Ten of Swords. Fuck, man. Okay. And the Queen of Pentacles. Okay. Six of Cups at the bottom, which is like, you're thinking back, whether recent past or way back, you're like, what could I have done differently? Is it me? It's like, I don't know, man. I don't know if this is something that, Six of Cups, High Priestess, and the Three of Cups. Is this something you knew for a long time, or you felt for a long time, but just was, like, ignoring? Man, and this could be between you and, like, somebody else. We have a Queen of Pentacles, could be an Earth sign, Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn. But, yeah, it's, like, King of Swords, Five of Cups, Ten of Swords, clarifying the Ten of Swords. It's just, like, you're seeing that, like, This is an ongoing pattern. This is an ongoing cycle. You're aware. This is maybe a subconscious thing, too, that you keep on witnessing, experiencing through your relationships. We have Three of Cups. Could be in your connections, friendships. And I just dropped the High Priestess again. This is Pisces energy as well. Y'all, this is heavy. I'm sorry you're going through this. Okay, so then, well, anyways, you're seeing that this ending, it's like, it's hard, it's emotional, but it's, like, necessary. Okay. So, High Priestess and Temperance. What's this about? I gotta let y'all go. Oh, my God. I gotta go, y'all. Okay. High Priestess, Temperance. Okay, this deck really doesn't want to shuffle anymore. Magician at the bottom. Let's see. High Priestess and the Temperance card for Libra. The Sun. Oh, what? I just accidentally grabbed a card myself. Three of Swords. Okay, but that's like transmuting that pain. We have the Page of Wands. That came out earlier. High Priestess and Temperance. Hey, the Magician was meant to be. It was meant to be. Okay, cool. We love her. We love him. And the Six of Cups. So, like, here's the thing. You might be kind of sad that this part, this chapter is kind of over. Like, this cycle is over. But you also see the positives, and you also see the blessings, you also see the good in this situation. And I think you're focusing more on that, or you're trying not to focus on what went wrong, or what didn't work, or what was lost. Like, I really am seeing here with the Sun and the Page of Wands, like, you're embracing this shift, you're embracing this change, and you're welcoming in, like, good things. And good things are coming towards you. So it's like not all was lost, and there's still a lot of great things in your life that you're focusing on and you're embracing and looking forward to. So it's like, you know, try not to focus on all the shit, because you have a lot of good things coming in, a lot of good things that are already in your life, and so you're embracing that. And also, you know, with the Magician and Six of Cups, there is something, this isn't like, whatever this ending is, I don't think it's like over, or like, it shows that you can do things, you can manifest something new out of the situation. Yeah, it shows that you can create something out of this. Like, it doesn't have to be like cut and dry and like that's it. Like, does that make sense? I'm sure it makes sense to somebody listening. Like, it shows Magician and the Six of Cups that this doesn't have to be over. It just, circumstances or something's got to change, right? Something's got to change. King of Pentacles, Five of Wands, and the Knight of Pentacles. It might take a little bit of time. It might take a little bit of adjustments. But clearly, like, again, if this is, like, you and another person not seeing eye to eye, or there's, like, some drama or clashing, maybe you just need a break, or maybe you just need some space or time to cool off, or again, it's about, you gotta be responsible here. Five of Wands and the King of Pentacles, like, you gotta be the mature person, or you gotta take the high road, or, again, there's something that's just, it's literally showing that there's something that's creating this destruction or chaos or drama, or just, like, it's just not worth it. And so you might need to, we go from the King of Pentacles to a Knight of Pentacles, so you might actually need to, like, take a few steps back from whatever this is. Oh, literally, thank you, Spirit, for confirming that. Literally, the Four of Pentacles. You might need to take a few steps back and then reconsider Two of Pentacles. We go from the King to the Knight to then the Four of Pentacles and then Two of Pentacles. You might want to take a few steps back, reconsider the situation, and then there's some necessary changes. It might freak you out, Nine of Swords, but honestly, Temperance, again, just like leaning into this, embracing this as best as possible, embracing this shift, and everything's gonna work out for you, Libra. Everything's working out for you. So I don't know, my throat's getting dry. I gotta go, Libra. I hope that this was helpful. I hope that you got something from this reading. Let me know in the comments below how this might resonate with you. I'd love to hear from you. I'd love to hear your feedback. We're gonna do your September reading next week, okay? So stay tuned for that, and I hope you have an amazing day. Private readings are available in the description box. I'm gonna let you go. Stay blessed. See ya, Libra.